of Friends. In the last 10 years, the Leagues of Friends of Devon have given you £18 million.
Yeah.
We expect some return. I plead with you, let's have consistency. By all means, have sustainable policy, sustainable services. By all means, have safe services. But the same applies to your policies. They must be consistent if we in the Leagues of Friends are going to raise money for you.
Thank you. Hear, hear. Vice Chair of Crediton League of Friends, I wholly support what you said there. We've actually been asked if we would consider to help funding an end of life programme to the tune of, you know, £100,000 over the years. Can you hear me?
No.
Should I say it again?
No.
Right. Now, you, as you said, you want our support financially. We've given and given and given. But we want to know, how do you justify and how are you going to integrate us into the system in reality? You want our money, but we lose our community beds. This money we raise and we give to you comes from the community, and we really want to see how we fit into this. It's a really important point. We want to help fund these things, but we want to make sure that it's not a bureaucratic exercise. It's really important. Thank you so much for letting me speak.
So we have got time for everybody to go home to table discussions. Hopefully it'll give every single one of you a chance to say something and have that recorded. Okay, so we'll take just a few minutes to try and just respond to some of the points. I'll go at a couple and I'll get my colleagues also to have a go. Shall I deal with this question of, you know, can we not get more money? How come we've got this problem? How come it's grown to such mammoth proportions in such a short space of time? Then perhaps get Angela to talk a little bit about the how we could work more effectively with voluntary organisations, League of Friends, and maybe also